Okay, now we'll talk about condensation. So this process is the changes of gas into a liquid. Okay, now condensations. Okay, so it is a process in which a gas changes into a liquid. Okay, so when you boil a water, gas produced from this very water, right? So this gas can be again reproduced into water. When a gas produced from a water, you take that gas and store it in a cool place for some few minutes. Okay, what will happen after storing it for a few minutes? It will again turn back to a water, right? Now next we have freezing and melting. So freezing means when a liquid turns into a solid substance. Okay, for example, you take a cup of water, store it in a cool place, 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, means for example, you take a cup of water and keep it in a freezer or a refrigerator for a hour or 3-4 hours. You keep it in a refrigerator. What will happen after freezing it for some few hours? That very water or liquid form, it will become into solid, right? Ice cube. It will turn into a solid form because the temperature is very low or very cool, right? So now we'll talk about melting. It is all very closely related to each other but opposite. So melting is a process. Now you take that ice cube which you have freeze in the freezer, right, and keep it in an open space. What will happen if you keep that ice cube in an open space? It will again turn back into liquid form, right? So this means melting. When a ice cube is kept on a open space, then it will turn into liquid form again, right, because of the temperature. So this is called melting. Freezing means when a liquid form turns into a solid form, and melting means when a solid form turns into a liquid form. So this is called freezing and melting. Okay, now next we have expansion and contraction in solids. So expansion and contraction means, expansion means becoming bigger in size, and contraction means becoming smaller in size. Okay, so with example, we'll talk about wooden wheel. Okay, so to put a iron ring on a wooden wheel, what do we do? We have to firstly put that iron ring in the fire, right, inside the fire, so that it becomes bigger in size, so that it expands in size. Okay, after expanding, you put a wooden wheel inside that iron ring, right? So when you put that iron ring in the fire, it becomes bigger in size, it expands its size, and after it expanded in a particular size, we put a wooden wheel inside the ring. When it is fitted or when it is fixed at the right position, we will keep it in a cool place so that it contract, right, so that it becomes smaller in size and becomes tight, right? So this is how we make a wooden wheel. Okay, so this means expansion and contraction. Expansion means becoming bigger in size, contraction means becoming smaller in size, right? You clear? Now we'll talk about chemical changes. So chemical changes is a changes which results in the formation of new substance. Okay, and these chemical changes are generally irreversible. That means it can't be turned back to the same form again. So for example, now you to cook a rice, what do we need? We need fire, we need water, we need a rice, right? Uncooked rice. So when you cook that food on a fire, it turns into a rice which is cooked, right? So can you turn back that cooked rice to uncooked? No, right? That means it is irreversible. So that means it is irreversible, right? So chemical changes are irreversible. Okay, so and also to produce a one substance or an object, in this very chemical changes, we need the help of another substance or another object. To burn a fire or to put a fire on a firewood, what do we need? We need the help of a match, right? That means we need another object or a substance to produce another substance or object. To produce a fire, we need the help of match or a lighter, right? So this is called chemical changes, and it can be turned back to the same form again. For example, burning. When you take a piece of paper, burn that very paper, it turns into an ashes, right? So can you turn that ashes back to the paper? No, right? So this is called irreversible changes, which occurs in chemical changes. Okay, only by the help of that very match you can turn the paper into ashes, right?